I'm true to my niggas. Why should I be true to you?
Why should I be true to you?
I'm true to my bitches. Why should I be true to you? I'm true to my hustlers. Why should I be true to you?
Why should I be true to you?
True to you. True to you.
What's poppin', folks? It's your boy HP, aka the Hookah Prince, and I'm back with another bang bang banger. Get it? So today's video is NHL players that abuse referees. I'm actually dying. I can't wait to watch this, because I be getting mad at the referees, man. They be pissing me off sometimes. But anyways, if you're new to the channel, subscribe to my channel, hit that bell notification button, and if you have any like video suggestions, like I told you before, hit me up on my Instagram DM or hit me up in the comments below and I will react to your video. So without further ado, let's just get into this video.
Hey everyone, what's up and welcome back to another video. Every sport has its untouchables, but while you have to achieve that status as a player, referees receive that status by default. They are given utmost authority and are protected at any cost, but every now and then something goes awry, and they are on the receiving end. This happens a lot in the NHL. So without wasting any further time, let's look at 8 NHL players that abused refs. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on anything. Alright, let's begin. Number 8, PK Subban. PK Subban was playing a game with the Montreal Canadiens in 2016. They had already had a 3-game winning streak, but you don't just get that by playing
That referee cost them this game. I remember this. Hard.
During the game, a pass was made by the Buffaloes that was
I lost money.
Subban had placed himself right in its way.
Saved
the goal, but the puck got stuck in the lineman's skates, and Evander Kane was able to get it back. This proved to be such an advantage that Evander shot at the empty goal, and the puck made it in. Subban was enraged and rushed the linesman with plenty to say, and none of it was pleasant.
That was some bullshit, bro.
Danny Carcillo. Over his career, Danny Carcillo has played for several renowned franchises, including New York Rangers, Philadelphia Flyers, and the Chicago Blackhawks. In 2014, as a member of the New York Rangers, Carcillo elbowed the ref and was subsequently thrown in the box. He was handed a 10-game suspension for his misdemeanor. However, it was later reduced to 6 games because of an appeal. Number 6, Sidney Crosby. Sidney Crosby, the captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins, is known for his aggressive behavior. He was recently
interference
call. But in 2017, he was in the direct crosshairs with Tampa Bay Lightning's Yanni Garod. Only 57 seconds after the game started, he was penalized for cross-checking Garod. But when he came back, he made it a point to be in the referee's face to voice his displeasure. Obviously, his way of voicing that concern wasn't cordial enough, with his unpleasant tone, and all in all, he found himself back into the box on a misconduct call. Number 5, Victor Hedman. In 2016, in a game between Tampa Bay Lightning and the San Jose Sharks, Victor Hedman aimed a mouthful at the ref. Much like Subban's case, the puck got stuck with the referee's skates and made way to the referee's goal. However, the real drama unfolded afterwards when Victor Hedman shot the puck down the ice. It unintentionally went past a referee who was too paranoid to let it pass. He gave Hedman a 10-minute misconduct penalty and sent him on the way to the box. But not before Hedman got some words in. Number 4, Dustin Byfuglien. Dustin Byfuglien is not the best when it comes to controlling his temper, which is why he has found himself amidst some real heat in the NHL. In a game against the Montreal Canadiens, when he came back from the box, he made it a point to slide up to the referee. During his verbal outburst on the referee, he bumped into him and got himself into another 10-minute misconduct. Number 3, Antoine Vermette. Antoine got himself into a strange situation when he tapped the linesman on the back.
I be feeling these players' pain, though, bro.
Like, out of
these referees, man, sometimes they out of control, man.
On basis of abuse.
Sometimes.
Number 2, Jesse Bullrice. Oftentimes, the players
but they always screw up
and try to make it look like an accident, but the intent is definitely there. Something of the sort went down in 2011 when Jesse Bullrice charged the referee during the game. He was suspended for 10 games even while it seemed that the referee got in his way due to the intentional charge. Number 1, Billy Cotu. Billy Cotu will always make it to the list of misdemeanors in the NHL no matter what the list is about. He's the only player in NHL history to be slapped with a lifetime ban. It was Game 4 of the Stanley Cup Final in 1972 when Billy Cotu began a brawl. He started it by punching a referee and tackling the assistant referee. The suspension was lifted in 1929 and he was reinstated in the league by 1932. Alright folks, this brings us to the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Well, if you did, then let us know by liking the video. Stick around for more amazing content as we will soon be seeing you in another video. Until then, take care and goodbye.
Man, Hey, man, but that's it for the video, man. Like I told y'all before, man, go check out this channel. It's called Sports Palace. Their videos are awesome. They have another video of referees getting abused. I think it was with them or Jens 95. It was Jens 95. But yeah, I'm going to react to that next. I'm going to definitely react to that next. Because I'm telling you, man, these referees, man, they be tweaking, bro. They be tweaking. They really be tweaking. I can't tell you how many times I lost money because of the referees. I swear to you. It was one point I lost like $580 because of the referee. It was like a playoff game like a few years ago. I was so mad. Man, but that's it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button and share it to your friends so they can tell their friend to tell another friend. And like I said before, I always tell y'all, chase y'all dreams, be yourself, live your life. It's your life. Live it how you want to live it. Just as long as it has a positive outcome. You know what I'm saying? Don't go out here and do nothing crazy. You know, and say, oh, HP told me to do it. No. Positive. You know, be positive. But anyways, I'm out. Y'all have a good night. Peace out. Bitch, they hard to find. It ain't no beer, man. I wake up in the morning. I be chopping. I be up my bed. I'm on the bed. I be swagging. I be rubbing. I be rubbing. I'll be Travis, shut the hell up.